friends, how are you?
Fine.
In the last lecture, we discussed about batteries, primary and secondary. We discussed, we are going to our new point of electrochemistry, fuel cell. Fuel cells, yes, here. First, we will discuss about getting electricity by which source. Everybody know, by thermal power station, by hydro power station, water mathi electricity mole hydro power station, in the burning of coal gives electricity. It is called thermal energy. We can derive some production of electricity by thermal source is not efficient, and it is a major source of pollution, major source of pollution. When coal burns, so it gives the heat, which heat we are using in the vaporization of water. So water vapor we are supplying into turbine, generate, then after generator huge magnetic field having a coil will be rotates, and due to that it gives electrical energy. So here our energy consumes in the converting of one energy to another, energy is consumed. So efficiency is very less of thermal power station, about only 40%. In such plants, chemical energy, that of combustion of fossil fuels. In the some plants, the chemical energy means burning of fossil fuel like coal gas, oil, coal gas like methane and oil, coal gas and oil burns, and chemical energy convert into electrical energy. So here a turbine produces electricity. We know that galvanic cell directly, we know galvanic cell converts electrical energy from chemical energy directly. Yes, here combustion occurs on the electrodes, so efficiency will be high of this type of cell, which is called a highly efficient, which is called a fuel cell. Yes, burning of fuel gives electrical energy from chemical energy. Efficiency is very high. It is now possible to make such fuel cells. In the compartment in the compartment we provide substances and product we can remove. So efficiently we get electricity. Yes, and one of the most important in as a fuel in this type of fuel cells like methane, methanol and hydrogen we are using as a fuel and we get some electricity. One of the most successful cell is a hydrogen cell, hydrogen fuel cell. One of the most successful cell is the hydrogen gas fuel cell. Yes, one of the most successful hydrogen and oxygen convert into water. The reaction of hydrogen with oxygen to form water called was used for providing electrical power. Hydrogen burns with oxygen and produce water. So it is pollution free. Yes, this cell is pollution free. In the Apollo program of Moon, Chandra upar yaan moklel Apollo. In the Moon, Apollo program of the Moon, this cell was used and produced vapor of the water condensed and used in drinking. Yes, it is well known. So diagram of this type of cell is here. Diagram of this cell. Yes, in the cell there are two walls which are made of the graphite and porous ekdam chidral wall of the carbon is made graphite, and in between concentrated NaOH is filled. Aqueous, one end of the wall we are passing hydrogen gas and another wall we are passing oxygen gas as a fuel. Here hydrogen burns with the oxygen as a catalyst. Here platinum or palladium powder for the speed. Yes, and outer both connected by switch. When we supply the oxygen and hydrogen, reaction will be started and it gives some electrical energy. In the cell there are two walls of graphite. Inside platinum or palladium powder is a catalyst used and between two electrodes means the walls aqueous concentrated sodium hydroxide is the filter. In the cell there are two walls of graphite. Inside platinum or palladium powder is a catalyst used for getting the high speed of the reaction. Speed up the reaction, we are using catalyst. Now, reaction of the cell. What happens? In the two electrode between NaOH aqueous solution is filled here, reaction start. On anode, oxidation occurs in the wall. Hydrogen are coming from one side of the wall and from another side OH minus coming into wall, and reaction start. 2H2 gas plus 4 OH minus ion gives one hydrogen atom releases one electron, so 4 hydrogen atom releases 4, so 4H2O and 4 electron it gives. Now on cathode, reduction occurs. Occurred electron produced move toward anode to cathode. And now coming electron reduces oxygen on the wall of the cathode. From one side oxygen is coming, from another side molecules of the water are coming into the wall. So O2 plus 2H2O liquid and 4 electron. Now in the water there are H plus and OH minus are two molecules, 2H plus and 2OH minus. One oxygen gains one electron, two oxygen gains 4. So O and H combines. So we get 4OH minus. This is the reaction. You can see transfer of electron occurs due to burning of hydrogen and oxygen. How much? 4 electron. So we can use as a electricity. Overall reaction being 4-4 cut, 4OH, 4OH cut, so 2H2 gas plus O2 gas gives 2-2 cut. So here 2H2O liquid it gives. This is overall reaction. The cell runs continuously. The cell runs continuously as long as the reactant are supplied. Reactants are supplied. We are supplying hydrogen and oxygen, so it will be runs continuously and it gives continuously voltage. Actually, this cell gives 1.23 volt, and efficiency of the cell is 70% compared to thermal power station. Thermal power station gives only 40% electricity efficiency. In thermal power station, efficiency only 40%, but this cell gives 70% having efficiency. There has been tremendous progress in the development of new electrode materials, better catalyst. Now scientists are trying to get more and more electricity from the fuel cell, and many cells are developed. And in future, we will use this cell is pollution free. Many cells are developed by scientists by using different kind of electrodes, different type of materials, and fuel cells pollution free. View of their future importance. A variety of fuel cells have been fabricated and tried. This one was a fuel cell, which is called hydrogen oxygen fuel cell. So here our cells are over, and last point of the chapter is a corrosion means pe katavu. Corrosion slowly coats the surface of a metallic object with oxide or other salt of the metal. Corrosion. What is corrosion? Corrosion is one kind of rusting. Kataijo in Gujarati. Corrosion slowly coats substances metallic substances. The substances like metallic object with the oxide. Or other metallic oxide over there. The rusting of iron by tarnishing of silver, example of corrosion. Yes, corrosion of iron, rusting of iron. The rusting of iron is a corrosion, then tarnishing of silver is shining chalcite due to layer of silver oxide over it, that is tarnishing of silver. Development green coating on copper and brass, copper and bronze. In the monsoon, green colored coating appears in the vessel of copper or bronze. That is also corrosion, rusting of iron, tarnishing of silver is shining major. The example of rusting are example of corrosion. It causes enormous damage to building, bridge, ships. Corrosion damages pool, vehicles, dam, bridge, buildings, bridges. So due to corrosion, we lose crores of rupees. Understood? Now come to corrosion. In corrosion, a metal is oxidized by loss of electron to oxygen and formation of oxide. actually in corrosion what happens? There is a chemical reaction in corrosion, loss of electrons by metal, and it combines with the oxygen and gives the oxide of the metals. That is the corrosion. Yes, sir. Corrosion of iron commonly known as rusting. Iron means locker. Iron is called rusting of iron. Corrosion of iron is called rusting of iron. It occurs in presence of water and air. It occurs in presence of air and the water. Corrosion occurs in the presence of the chemistry of corrosion is quite complex. The chemistry of corrosion is complex, but we can understand by electrochemistry. Yes, sir. And a particular point, yes, we are taking now chemistry of corrosion. Actually, what chemical reaction occurs during corrosion? When we take any cross section of iron, iron piece is taken here. Generally, iron core is good. Corrosion start at the point where edge is irregular surface, irregularity in the arrangement of the atoms, corrosion occurs there. Particular point where Fe experiences oxidation inside the iron plate. Iron, this is water. In the water, H2O, oxygen and H plus ion are present there. At particular point, which bears like anode. So here first, Fe loses 2 electron and convert into Fe plus 2 ion. So 2 Fe solid loses 2 electron and 4. Here, oxidation potential of it is plus 0.44 and reduction potential means Fe plus 2 oblique Fe is minus 0.44. Reduction potential is negative but oxidation is positive. So losing nature of electron is high of the iron in the presence of air. So here Fe is now converted into Fe plus 2 and it moves toward outer surface from its place, yani bar outside, where oxygen is present. So reduction occurs there. O2 plus 4H plus ion and 4 electron. So 4H plus gains 4 electron, 4 hydrogen, 2 oxygen. So gives 2H2O liquid there. Understood? Now here H plus coming from where? Yes, that is the point. Carbon dioxide in the air is present which dissolves into water and convert into carbonic acid. Water my H plus to khub less hoy. Atla bada kya thi aiva? From atmosphere. Moist सरफेस ऊपर जो वाटर है एम कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड डिजोल्व हो सो दिस कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड आयोनाइजेस एंड रिलीजेस एच प्लस आयन इन द मॉइस्ट सो मैक्सिमम एच प्लस आयन ड्यू टू कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड प्रेजेंट इन अवर एयर एंड इट गिवस इन द मॉइस्ट मैक्सिमम एच प्लस आयन नाउ इलेक्ट्रॉन released at anodic spot move through the metal and go to another spot where here reduction potential H plus in the presence of oxygen and convert into H2O equal to 1.23 volt yes here reduction potential is plus 1.23 3 volt. So overall reaction of both 2 Fe solid 4-4 cut plus O2 plus 4H plus gives 2 Fe plus 2 and 2 H2O liquid. Here, E degree cell is 1.67. E degree cell of the overall cell is the overall cell reaction is 1.67. Occurred electron from Fe moves through the metal in the space where water no कोई ड्रॉप छे ई बिहेव्स लाइक अ कैथोड वेयर रिडक्शन अकर्स ओ टू एच प्लस एन फोर इलेक्ट्रॉन आर कमिंग सो रिडक्शन अकर्स देयर सो ओवरऑल रिएक्शन इज लाइक दिस बट वंस अगेन एफ ई प्लस टू आयन व्हेन मूव्स टुवर्ड द सरफेस इट कंबाइन्स विथ वाटर टू एफ ई प्लस टू आयन टू एच टू ओ plus 1/2 O2 one time again it experiences oxidation Fe convert into Fe plus 3 as Fe2O3 oxygen sathe combine thai here 4 hydrogen H plus maximum release thai and 2N1 3 Fe2O3 this is our rust so formula of the rust of iron is asked so it should be Fe2O3 into XH2O yes sir. Ferric oxide now it is a ferric oxide deposit over and maximum H plus iron produces this reaction Fe convert into Fe plus 2 now release electron move toward cathode where air moist water drop is present on the surface it behaves like a cathode so here Fe plus 2 ion moving toward the surface and this Fe plus 2 ion once again combines with oxygen and water and convert into ferrous into ferric and Fe2O3 rusting will be spread over the surface of the iron that is called a rusting Now, prevention of corrosion. Yes. Prevention of corrosion. Prevention. How do we prevent our metals? Prevention. Rusting ne roku. Prevention of corrosion. Is of prime importance. It not only saves money, but also helps. In preventing accidents such as a bridge collapse, bridge to design and failure of key component due to corrosion. Yes, bridge to design. Buildings. Building will be corrosed. Yes, we are metal. We are using metals in the building. One of the simple method. One of the simple method to prevent corrosion of the metal object to come contact with the atmosphere. To prevent metal comes contact with the atmosphere. In atmosphere sir contact how is it? No. So we are doing paint over the metals. अपने painting करिए चाहिए, color करिए चाहिए over the metals and some chemicals like biphenol, bisphenol we are using to prevent corrosion. Another simple method is cover the surface by other metals. Other methods is cover the metal by other metals like zinc and tin etc. Now listen, if our iron is coated with tin, actually oxidation potential of iron is higher than oxidation potential of tin. If some of the tin is removed from the surface, so corrosion will be started. So this is a temporary, not permanent. If a tin is present, surface is totally covered, then never iron corrosion. If some tin is removed, then surface is coming contact with the air, so iron will be corrosion. But in the case of magnesium or zinc, if iron is coated by zinc, which is called a galvanized iron, so here oxidation potential of zinc is higher than Fe. If some of the zinc is removed from the surface and iron is come contact with air, but it never been corrosive. Why? Zinc is more reactive. So up to last atom, only zinc behaves like anode and I feel like a cathode. So iron never corrosive in presence of zinc, which is called magnesium also. Highly reactive than iron. So corrosion occurs of only magnesium and zinc in the presence of iron. So that is called the sacrificer. Zinc, tin is not. Zinc and magnesium is called sacrificer. sacrificers. Zinc and magnesium is called sacrificers. It saves the object. Yes, sir. In steamer, in ship, yes, which is made of iron, but there is a plate of magnesium and zinc. So I am never coarsed. So after interval of time, we have to change plates of magnesium and zinc. In the electrical pole, inside the soil, iron with the magnesium or zinc plate present there. So iron will be never coarsed in the presence of a zinc. Zinc will be coarsed, but iron never coarsed. So zinc and magnesium are called sacrificers of the iron. Sacrificer, sacrificial electrode. Now our chapter is here over. Now last 3 point of index question we are going to discuss. Write the chemistry of recharging the lead storage battery. Yes, point write the chemistry of recharging of lead storage battery. Understood? So now first in lead storage battery actually discharge the cell is working. So at anode Pb solid plus SO4 minus 2 gives PbSO4 plus 2 electron. Now on cathode reduction occurs. So PbO2 plus SO4 minus 2, 4H plus and 2 electron. Yes. Pb plus 4 gains 2 electron convert into PbSO4 and releasing of 2 mol water. This reaction occurs during discharge. But when we recharge, here also, our solution is 38% weight by weight of concentrated sulfuric acid. So density of sulfuric acid decreases. But when we recharge anode with the cathode from outer another battery and cathode with the anode, when we join, so on our original anode, reaction became inverse. PbSO4 plus 2 electron. PbSO4 once again convert into Pb and release SO4 minus 2 into solution. Now in our original cathode actually oxidation occurs. So PbSO4 inverse of it. I can inverse here, here like this PbO2. But plus SO4 minus 2, 4H plus and 2 electron. But recharge capacity is not 100%. So every lead sulfate occurred during discharge is not converting completely into lead and PbO. So lack of sulfuric acid in the solution occurs. The sulfuric acid density decreases. So after time of internal, we have to add amukamuk time 38% weight by weight H2SO4 we have to add. Yes sir. And after many times discharge, sometimes electrodes we have to change also. Now 3.15. 3.14 first term suggests that to suggest to materials other than hydrogen that can be used as fuels in fuel cells. So we know methane and methanol we are using the methane and methanol. Now question number index question 3.15 is explain the how rusting of iron. Explain the rusting of iron. Our last question we discussed answer of eta. Yes, in the atmosphere contains acidic gases like CO2. We discussed last lecture, last point, rusting of iron. So that is our answer. Here our chapter electrochemistry is over. Now we will meet with our new chapter in next lecture. Bye. Take care.